Hello, fabulous friends, fans, and superstars. Welcome to your horoscope for the week of July 23rd, 2017. I am your astrologer, Nadia Shaw. Thank you for being here. And what a week it is. This week is when August really begins. Like, actually, when we look at the energy, when we look at the lessons, when we look at where it is and how it is, the universe is going to invite us to bring forward greater love and greater wisdom as it constantly is. This is the week where the energy shifts and it starts to move in a direction that is only going to be further fulfilled as we get into August and as we get into eclipse season. As a lot of people know, there's a lot of buzz out there about the solar eclipse set to take place a month from now. That solar eclipse is happening in the sign of Leo. And it is a powerful one. It is happening close to Mars, speaking with Saturn, speaking with Uranus. So there's heightened energy in the air and a heightened call to change, to create opportunity, to own our power, and to act in a way that affects lasting change and lasting benefits in our life. Well, this month, we've also got a new moon. So what is a solar eclipse? A solar eclipse is like a new moon, but I like to call it a jacked up new moon. It's like 30 times more powerful than your normal new moon. But a new moon essentially is fresh energy, fresh beginnings. It's a chance to plant seeds. It's a chance to start over in at least one area of life, if not more. So we have got this call with the eclipse coming up in a month's time to align with a higher, more loving vision for our life. Essentially, eclipses allow us to put our past away, to put our ego aside, and consider instead a more loving vision for our life and a more fated path that we could be on that ultimately is the path towards greater love and greater wisdom as part of our unique journeys. So this new moon happening in the same sign is a lot more subtle. It's happening at the very beginning of its sign, and it is an energy that has a strong intuitive quality to it. It's more subtle. It's more encouraging. Mars is close by as well, so it's asking us to get in touch with what we know about ourselves to be true. It has a self-knowledge element and also acting from a place of self-knowledge, which is what Mars is in its highest vibration. So this is where we get the prompt. This is where it's kind of casual or it's kind of low key, may even not even be a big event, but this is where we hear about something happening in a month's time that we should be at. This is where we start to understand that there could be an opportunity that could materialize for us. This is where we start to feel that there's something else that we'd rather be doing, that there's some other relationship calling us, that there's another group of people that we could be with. And ultimately, it is what we do right now that will determine how dramatic that eclipse is going to be. So if you are a person who strives to be conscious, who regularly checks in with yourself, who cares about living in alignment with your heart, the desires and the truth of your heart, who desires to own your light and shine bright and know that you are worthy of that, then this can be a time of a lot of beginning reflection and a time that helps you to align perfectly with the accelerated energy that is going to come with the eclipse 1 month down the road. If you're not so much, you know, if you're happy with your life and you're doing your thing and you're fine with that, you're not necessarily thinking about self-knowledge and consciousness and things like that, then what tends to happen is eclipses tend to be a little bit more, if not a lot more, of a surprise. So just be prepared for that, regardless of where you are right now. This is a great time to listen to yourself and to consider where it is that you are being nudged, gently nudged, whether it's within yourself, whether it is to be more honest with yourself, or in your life with the opportunities that are showing up. So as I said, August starts right now. We are about to accelerate our lessons. Right now, it's subtle. We get into August. We will start eclipse season. We'll have an eclipse in August, in Aquarius, a full moon eclipse, and then of course, the very big, very visible eclipse, the new moon solar eclipse that will take place a month from now, 28 and a half days from now. And that is when the full potential and the full blessings of this time will more fully be known. They may not be known necessarily, apparently, right away, but that is when they will come out in the full light of day and be that much more clear. The thing with eclipses is, it's like what was always in front of your face. It was there all along, but you just didn't see it. It comes out and is shown to you in a very dramatic way. And after the fact, you're like, well, obviously. Well, yeah, of course. But when you're in the middle of it, maybe not so much. So in order to minimize some of that, oh, that was really obvious. How did I not see that? This is the time to go within and to listen. In that way, when what was always there but wasn't so clear becomes clear, you're able to grab it and run with it and make the most of it. But of course, that's not all that's happening this week. There's other important things happening this week. One, of course, is the fact that Venus is going to stand across the sky from Saturn. Now, this I mentioned a couple of weeks ago that this was coming up. I said, you know, right now Venus is doing all kinds of beautiful, sweet things. Venus was speaking in supreme harmony with Jupiter. I said, enjoy the love because Venus will get to this point. And this point is Venus standing across Saturn from the sky. And it is moment of truth time where it comes to love. Not always easy, depending on where you are in the context of love, in your relationship or otherwise. But when Venus stands across the sky from Saturn, it represents a time when we are invited to be more honest with ourselves about what we really feel about a particular either romantic dynamic or financial dynamic as well. It is a time when we may feel a sense of obligation. There may be a sense of responsibility. There may be, I must admit, a sense of some restriction as well, having to accept certain truths, having to accept certain realities that may not always be so easy or as easy as we may necessarily like, especially when you consider just a couple weeks ago, we had Venus speaking in supreme harmony with Jupiter. That was so hopeful. That was so romantic. That was so, you know, believing that everything will be great and amazing, and absolutely it can be. But these are the moments that sort of ask us to check in with ourselves and ask us what's really going on, so that it isn't just about what we are perceiving and getting carried away on a cloud, but that there is a sense of balance so that we are grounded at the same time. So as far off the ground you've been is as much as it will feel that you are grounded that much more. But again, if you strive to be conscious, if you strive to be pretty balanced, then this can be a time where you start to appreciate the value of having a more measured perspective. This is the time when you start to appreciate more that, you know, sometimes people are most beautiful when we're able to see their imperfections. Sometimes love is most great when we are able to make sacrifices for it. But some sacrifices may not be worth making. So checking in with ourselves, making sure that we are operating on full integrity is the surest way to ensure self-respect. Bringing love and self-respect together is part of the sacred learning right now. Now also this week, the sun will meet Mars in the sky. So talk about heightened energy, heightened passion. I mean, this is just carrying forward that new moon energy further into the week. And this will allow self-knowledge. The sun is intellect and rationality and prophecy. Mars is self-knowledge and self-containment and action that arises from that place. Now, these, of course, are the higher manifestations of these energies. The not so high manifestation of these energies, of course, Mars, adrenaline junkie, Sun, egocentric. So the two of these meeting together, and again, your consciousness will determine so much of how this energy is realized in your life, but the two of these meeting together magnify each other's fire and passion. So whatever it is that you are truly passionate about, whatever it is that truly sets your heart alight, sets your heart on fire, is going to be made very evident. At the very least, this is some very passionate energy. I might have said passionate already, but yeah, good time to go out there and get some exercise or meet some new people or spend time with someone that you love and enjoying the feeling of life. That really is a big part of what Mars is about. And Mars and the Sun together, can magnify that desire to feel alive, to feel fully alive. And this is that opportunity to know what it is that that means for you in your unique journey. Now, finally, Mercury. We got to talk about Mercury because Mercury this week will speak in supreme harmony with Uranus. I absolutely love this. This is great for signing documents, and I would suggest doing that in the earlier part of the week, but signing documents or having a surprise conversation, being especially brilliant and witty and brainstorming and just being amazed at your ability to just come up with the right words at the right tempo. So this is beautiful energy. It can be very flirty as well. So I would invite you to engage with this energy. Right after that, what will happen is Mercury will enter shadow. Yes, Mercury retrograde season begins this week as well, with Mercury entering shadow. And then before the week is out, we'll enter the sign of Virgo, where most of the retrograde season will take place. So do pay attention to what takes place in your life right now this week, because the themes that arise now will be returned to a few weeks down the road. And of course, I'll be here to talk about it as we go along. But as I look at this particular sky, I feel like there is, on the one hand, energy that says, go, get them. There's a sense of urgency. There's a sense of determination, which is really beautiful. And at the same time, there's energy this week that says, reflect. Understand that things are cycles. Life is cycles. And that it isn't over. You're going to get another shot. You're going to get more than one shot. You'll get a chance to go over it again. You'll get a chance to know yourself more deeply in the process. This week has a lot of magic to it, but a lot of the magic has to do with understanding that magic is a process. As they say, there is no magic pill, there is a magic process. We are right now engaged in a very sacred and very magical process that will lead us back to the truth of our hearts, that ultimately leads us back to the most loving and wise parts of ourselves. Well, thank you so much for watching. I'm truly so grateful for it. Please like, comment, subscribe, share, thumbs up. It means so much. And check out astrofabulous.com or nadiashah.com for your instant access to exclusive expanded video scopes this week for each and every sign. I focused on that new moon. I gave a heads up on the eclipse. So what both of those are going to mean and how they fit together. And also for each sign, I talked about Venus standing across the sky from Saturn and what it means for you. So again, log on to my website, nadiashah.com or astrofabulous.com. And I look forward to meeting you in the superstar space. Sign up to be one of my superstars. Love my superstars. Love my friends and fans. Thank you so much. And thank you to the new superstars who join each and every day. Thank you to the amazing people that came out to my Toronto meetup. I just love you guys. Thank you. A lot of love in the room. And I appreciated it so much. And I appreciate you guys as well. You can check out synchronicityuniversity.com for previous classes, instant webinar downloads. And of course, there are Synchronicity University classes here on YouTube as well. I think that's it for announcements. I'm really grateful for you. Thank you. Thank you for being a part and sharing a part of your sacred journey with me and being a part of mine as well. I'm so grateful for it. It'll be a great week. Enjoy.